y'all. God will touch them in the meantime. Don't think that them coming up front and even imitating raising hands, that's allowing God to touch them. That's how we all learn to play. That's why we have kitchens and cash registers around our house and all that play, because one day they'll be doing it. It may seem like play, but who knows what God is doing while we're bringing to God for God to touch them. The third thing is the opposition. The disciples, they rebuke those who brought them. Wouldn't you think that of all people, the disciples would want the children to come and be with Jesus? But they're the ones that put up walls. Don't think that raising children to serve God and be in the presence of God will not have its oppositions. If God can get someone to criticize you, or if the devil can get someone to criticize you for bringing your children to God, if the devil can get something to stick in your mind that makes you hesitant to bring, he'll bring opposition. There will be opposition in raising children to be in the presence of God. But the end result will be worth it. Jesus is suffering your children. He comes against the opposition. In closing, I want to say a couple of verses. Psalms 127:3, the Bible says that children are an heritage of the Lord. You know why you have children? No child's a mistake. Because it's a heritage of God. Rachel, this is your heritage. Jeff, this is your heritage. Terry, Bobby, it's your heritage. Moms and dads here, it's your heritage. And the Word of God says this, that a man who has a quiver full, well, he's a happy man. What's a quiver full, Sister Ange? Your quiver may look fuller than mine, but mine's full because that's how much God gave me. And someone else's may be full because God just gave them one. Whatever God gives you, amen, thank God for the quiver that He has given you. But I want to tell you something, that God doesn't give you a quiver full of arrows just for you to march around and show them off. Arrows are meant to be used for something. Any of you ever shoot a bow? All right, I see some of you back there. What's that young man? I forget your name. Is it Isaac? Isaiah?
Caleb.
Ah, see ya. When you get old, you mix everybody up. That's me. What did you do with that arrow? What did you do with it?
Shot it at a target.
A target? What, did you want to hit the tree? What did you want to hit?
The target.
The target. It's common sense, isn't it? And so when God gives us arrows, God also gives us a target. And every child's family. And so we should be shooting tonight. God help Layla at the target. She has four individuals that will be shooting her at the target. But Curtis, Strange, you got to hit the target tonight. But Curtis, to Rachel, you got to hit the target tonight. Molly, we've got to hit the target tonight. Little Marcus, for me, you've got to hit the target tonight. And so it's heavy that God has given us children. But with that, there comes a responsibility to make sure that we hit the mark. And so God, help us to take the opportunity to get them to Jesus. And God, help us to take the opportunity in their youth to get them there. And God, help us to realize that in the middle of the opportunity, amen, that there is an objective that we want. That's Brother David, for God to touch them. Your grandpa, you still want God to touch all your children. You want God to move in every one of their lives. And now there's grandchildren. Sister Tina, you have a grandson. You want God to work in his. You want God to touch him. You're influential on that. your influential nation. And I heard hitting the target. For tonight, let's not miss the target. Amen, Sister Holly. And then I asked her if she would sing a song for Layla. Would you come and do that tonight? Amen. And then we're going to gather around our families and pray. So, Jeff and Rachel, Bob and Terry, Layla, this song is for you tonight.
Different prayers I pray for all that you might do.